This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday, the 29th of October. I'm Georgina White. Commonwealth Conference pledges developmental governance. Spanish group protests Gibraltar nuclear base. Press office responds to Lord Monckton accusations. Ocean Village boasts €800 million SuperYacht haul. And finally, Griffon Vulture lands in Gibraltar. Minister for Employment Joe Bozzano attended the Commonwealth Ministers' Forum in New Delhi recently. The forum's salient theme was public service promoting economic growth and development. Minister Bozzano participated in all the debates held at the conference and also attended each ministerial forum meeting with other ministers. The conference concluded that emphasis must be put on the challenges presented by the financial crisis, social upheavals and environmental concerns. It was also noted that there is an urgent need for steady economic growth and job creation as a means of delivering essential services and national resilience. As a result of the discussions, it was agreed that developmental governance should be prioritised in order to strengthen the capacity of the relevant public institution. On Saturday, a group of Spanish protesters gathered around the frontier gates on the La Línea side in protest of the ROC's military base. Members of PCA as well as other concerned citizens gathered to form the Andalusian platform against military bases. According to reports in Europa Sur, the protesters urged the government to denuclearize the Strait of Gibraltar. One member even insisted that Spain has been used as a platform for US military action after the group rejected the bilateral treaty that Spain has with the US. The group claimed that military funding should go to education and healthcare. In response to a statement released by climate sceptic Lord Monckton, the government press office has restated their version of the events that led to Monckton receiving his press accreditation for the Thinking Green seminar. It was noted that they received a call from a Mr. Scott 2 days after the deadline for press accreditation on Thursday the 18th of October, asking if it would be possible for a press pass to be issued in the name of Lord Monckton. The team confirmed that the pass would be ready for collection on the following day. The press office also stresses that none of the computers used to receive emails in any of the departments contain any record of the 2 dates and times that Monckton claims to have tried to get in contact with the team. This weekend saw Ocean Village Marina's highest collective value of superyachts, with 7 vessels, adding up to €800 million altogether, berthed at the marina. The first was a German-built 74-metre, former winner of the World Superyacht Awards. The vessel can hold 12 guests and boasts on an on-deck jacuzzi and outdoor cinema. Commenting on the busy week, Commercial Director for Ocean Village, Brian Stevendale, noted that despite the Spanish making every attempt to blockade Gibraltar, the superyachts have no such problem as they make their way into the marina en route from a summer in the Mediterranean. And finally, this weekend traffic came to a halt near the Sundial roundabout as a very lost Griffon Vulture landed in Gibraltar. It is likely that the bird of prey was migrating towards Africa as the colder weather settles in through Europe. The vulture was eventually picked up by a GONS officer who may keep the bird for a few days until it is healthy and prepared to continue its flight. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.